This ain't a matter of luck, Kate. It's all skill.
Any skill, Drew?
Nope.
Maybe it's your bait. What are you using?
Live mackerel on a three-hook, hot pink and chartreuse spin glow harness, backed by a sonic spoon, steel leader, and half a dozen assorted doodle bobbers.
Sort of the buffet approach. I prefer the simple method.
And what's that?
Ham sandwich.
Oh, boy, you may be the star of the family when it comes to everything else, Kate. But when it comes to fishing, you're entering Drew County. Population one. Take it from me, no fish is going to be dumb enough to...
do that.
Well, it's past midnight, kid. Best go home and get some shut-eye.
Oh, you two go ahead. I'll help Tran close up.
Any luck tonight, son?
Fishing ain't a matter of luck, Daddy. It's all skill.
Any skill, Drew?
Now, stop that. You go home. Thank you.
Miss McCrory today.
What, you mean she ain't here yet?
No.
Well, that's odd. I figured she got up early and beat us down here. Drew, you hear your sister come in last night?
Oh.
Well, all right. Katie! Katie, are you okay? Huh? Here, come on. Let me get your...
Whoa! Listen, when you get some time, let me show you how to operate a mirror.
Miss McCrory, what happened?
Fish. Big fish. The fight all night.
What big fish? Where?
Can Tran get you something?
Thirsty. Water. Quick.
I know my English bad, but you not have to talk like Tonto.
I don't believe it.
Yeah, it's me.
No, not you, Mayor. Katie's fish.
Katie caught a fish.
Fish? Hell, you could put a saddle on it.
That's the biggest thing I've seen caught off this pier since Drew hooked his mama inner tubing.
Could we be talking about a record here?
Could be.
Really? A record?
Oh, wait a minute. Come on, Daddy. You know I caught one much bigger.
I don't think Mom was a keeper, Drew.
I'm talking about that record fish I caught 10 years ago. Well, people came from miles around just to see it, and everybody said that was a record that would never fall.
Come on, Walt, let's measure that mark.
Are you coming, Drew?
Hey, you want to waste your time, you go right ahead. Four. I'm just going to sit right here and count my feet.
True. You don't have to worry. I don't want your record.
Well, the mayor would like to make an official pronouncement.
Thank you. Tough rocks, Kate. You lost back quarter inch.
Oh, boy. Hey.
Well, it's a good thing they measure the record by length and not weight, Drew. I think my fish was fatter. Oh, no.
Well, by God, it's been so long since we had a contender, I forgot.
Come on, let's weigh that guppy.
Hi. That record really meant a lot to you, didn't it?
Well, sure it did. 10 years had been who I was. Guy who caught the big one.
Drew, you're still the guy who caught the unusually large one.
This ain't about some stupid fish, Katie. I'm 28 years old. What have I accomplished?
I know. No, that was me. Okay. You were an All-American football player.
Junior college, second team 8 years ago. Since then...
Well, sometimes I think the only reason God put me on this earth was so beer would have something to pass through.
Well, without getting caught up in theology or biology, Drew, your life is not over. You're still young. Hey, don't you have any dreams?
Well, sure. Well, I got this one where I oversleep and run to school half groggy. When I get there, not only am I late for the big test, but I'm standing in front of the whole class in my underwear.
That wasn't a dream, Drew. It happened fifth grade.
Still haunts me.
What I mean is something you've always dreamed of doing.
Well, sure, I mean... Well, there is one thing.
What?
No, forget it. Katie, it's too crazy to even talk about. I mean, besides, it's way too late for that.
So true. It's never too late to realize your dreams. You have to reach for the stars. If anything is possible... Speaking entirely in cliches, for instance. The point is, you can accomplish anything you set your mind to.
Just give it up, Kate, all right? I mean, my dreams have passed me by like I was a hitchhiker carrying a chainsaw.
Okay. I can see I'm just wasting my time. You'll just have to settle for being the biggest fish in a small pond. Oh, wait, that'll be the second.
Oh, just stop it, Kate, all right? I know what you're doing. You're trying to goad me into doing what's best for myself. Well, forget it, because I'm not falling for it.
Oh,
hey, this is me leaving.
Boy, this dream better turn out better than the one with me in my underwear.
Oh, come on. I mean, how crazy of a dream could we be talking about?
It's real crazy.
Oh. Wait a minute. You mean ha-ha crazy or his neighbor said he seemed like such a quiet boy?
Well, howdy, Mayor.
Morning, Walt. Still pulling double duty, I see.
No, just duty and a half. I'm filling in for Drew. He hadn't been around much since his sister convinced him to follow his dream.
Anyone have any idea yet what this dream of Drew's is?
Beats me what the boy's up to. All I know, he's been firing off letters, making phone calls all week.
Maybe he wants to be a receptionist.
Instead of constantly making fun, you could be a little more supportive of Drew. Come on, everybody. When Drew comes in, I want everyone to let him know we support him, no matter what the endeavor.
Oh, jeez. You ever get a chigger bite where you can't quite reach it?
You can reach it, Drew.
Go for it.
Hey, it's here.
Here.
Oh, boy. Yes, are my dreams in this letter.
Woo! Paper cut or is that old chigger bag?
It's better. I got a tryout with the Houston Oilers.
I'm going to play pro football!
you're just tying our tails together.
Come on, Drew. No, you guys! My old college coach, he's a scout for the Oilers now. He got me a tryout. Hey, I know making it's a long shot, but Katie here told me anything's possible.
Anything is possible, Drew, and we're behind you 100%.
Oh, boy, thanks, Katie. Whew, it's just, I've never really been away from home before. I mean, this is kind of scary. I'm not sure I'm up to it.
Oh, Drew, football was the joy of your life. When you were growing up, you'd tackle anything that wasn't nailed down. We went through a lot of heck. Yeah.
What do you think, guys? Can I really do this?
Now, guys!
Yeah.
Sure!
You out of your mind, Katie? That boy's 28 years old. It's way too late for this.
Your daddy is right, Katie. You're setting that boy up for the biggest humiliation of his life.
Shh. Oh, I thought this was the best news that anyone could ever hear.
No, that'd be, it's only temporary and happens to a lot of men.
Guess what came? A letter from Drew.
Oh!
Oh, am I popular again?
Just give us the bad news. Where do we claim the body?
He's cynical. Let's see. He says he is adjusting well to showering in groups. Oh, they announced the first cut? And you probably don't want to hear the rest.
Oh, that poor kid's going to break his heart.
I knew he should.
He made it! He made it! He made the first cut!
Made the first cut!
Let's see you walk away from me now.
Beer's on the house!
Boy, if he makes that team, he's going to be the biggest thing that ever come out of this town.
Well, I'm not surprised. I knew all those hours of teaching him practically everything he knows about the game would pay off.
Well, now, wait a minute, Walt. I'm the one who passed my old football equipment down to him when he was in the fifth grade. Good thing I did, too, because that was the day he showed up to practice in his underwear. Why didn't he just go home, Walt?
Excuse me, Reality Patrol here. Well, I don't want to be a credit hog, but oink, oink. I mean, if it were not for me, Drew would not be where he is today.
Hey, everybody. I'm back.
Hey, Drew, it looks like you've mastered that contraption.
Sort of.
Where you been all afternoon?
Getting the paper.
wasn't there.
Drew, can I do anything for you? Get you an iced tea, a cold beer? Why don't you use me for a ramp?
No, now, Katie! Katie, now, cut it out. Come on, get her out of there.
Really?
Come on, I'll take you down. Just let me see.
Get her out of the way. Okay.
Hold
on.
Hold on. Hold on. Hold on. There you go.
Thanks,
good. Okay, all right.
No, I'm fine. I'm okay.
Okay,
mind as
you
pop now.
I got it.
Don't worry about me, boy.
Katie, are you okay?
No. It's been 3 days and Drew won't look at me, he won't talk to me, he won't even acknowledge me. I'm pretty sure he's not going to thank me for bringing in his newspaper. He must really hate me.
Oh, no, no, he doesn't, honey! He's just depressed because his football days are over. Let's face it, the boy's dream turned on him.
Ran him down.
Clotheslined him.
Crushed him like
okay.
a...
Okay! Gee, I feel guilty enough as it is. Y'all know it was my fault.
Oh, now, Katie, no one person is responsible. We all took credit when he was doing good, so we all deserve a share of the blame.
But I'm the one who caught the fish that broke his record. I'm the one who goaded him into playing football. I'm the one who filled out his forms. I packed his bag. Drove him to the bus.
Shoot. When you get right down to it, she done everything but call the play that flattened him.
Stay here and talk to me.
About what?
The weather, fishing, what I can do to make you... Please, please, please forgive me.
What?
Well, look at you. You look like hell, Drew. On wheels. I feel terrible. I come barging back here and muck up your life. And if you're going to hate me for the rest of your mucked up life... Well... Maybe I shouldn't stay.
Katie.
Look, if anything, you should hate me. I'm the one who let you down.
Let me down? Why? Just because you didn't make the team?
No.
Well, why would I possibly hate you?
Okay. I'll tell you. But you've got to promise me that you will never, ever breathe word of this to anyone.
Promise.
Cross your heart? Hope to die?
Hope to die.
Stick a needle in?
Drew.
Okay. You just remember. You promise. I learned something at training camp, Katie. What I learned is that I belong right here. Boy, because when I'm not, I get homesick, something awful.
You're faking?
What else could I do? Now, you know how folks are around here, man. If they found out that I quit just because I was homesick, they'd run me out of town. Which is pretty ironic when you think about it.
I have been pulling my hair out with guilt, and this whole time, you have been faking!
Actually, I do have a jam pinky.
Oh, I'll show you a jam pinky.
Ah!
What I mean to say, he is not injured enough. You are mine, Roller Boy.
Now, Katie, hey, get down now. You all right, Drew?
I think so, Daddy.
Oh, here, wait. Let me get your chair. Come on. I don't know. know what's going on out here, but I do know what is going to happen now. I'm going to take you back to the house where your loving sister is going to wait on you hand and foot until you're properly healed.
What?
You heard what I said, young lady. Now, how long do you reckon that's going to take, son?
Oh, Daddy, that could take...
Look into my eyes, Drew.
Not long. Not long at all, Daddy.
Well, good.
Oh, yeah, see that.
What? Jesus!
It's Drew.
I'm Corbin Burnson. You know, in spring, a young man's fancy turns to thoughts of love. I could do that anytime. I'm hosting Saturday Night Live with Smithereens.
Air pollution, oil spills, and toxic waste are destroying our environment. What can we do to stop it? Find out when NBC News programs go on assignment Earth all next week.